Good evening, I'm Emily Violi, this year's student director of Anything Goes.
And I'm Grace Trocano, this year's assistant student director. Tonight's performance is dedicated to the Theater Angels. The show is underwritten in part by PNC Wealth Management and Highmark Incorporated. We would also like to acknowledge the support of Woomer and Hall. Without the support of these sponsors, we would not be able to buy the supplies that we needed for our theaters this year.
Each year, our musical family chooses one charity to collect money for. This year, we've chosen the Alzheimer's Association of Pittsburgh in the name of John C. Hall. If each audience member is able to donate $1, you can help us reach our goal.
We would like to inform the audience that simulated gunfire is used during their production.
Boarding for the SS American is about to begin.
Bon voyage.
Charlie Blodgett was a liar and a drunk.
He is, but he's a Yale man.
What's the road, sir?
The usual. Evening, gentlemen.
Anybody call for me, Fred?
Harriet, Nancy, Lorraine, two Lorraines.
How about Hope? Hope Harcourt?
No, but there was a lady who came in asking for you.
He's wrong, Billy. It was only me.
Reno, oh my God, we had a date.
That's okay. I'd say forget it, but you already did.
Reno, I'm sorry. My boss is going to London in the morning. I had to do 1,000 things for him.
I'm going to London in the morning, and all you had to do for me was buy me a drink.
What'll it be, ma'am?
A martini, only make it with rye and put a cherry in it instead of an olive.
Two Manhattans, Fred.
You know, I'm getting worried about you, Billy. I'm not sure this Wall Street job is good for you.
Hey, I'm making $35 a week.
Yeah, but look at you. Look at what you're wearing.
What's the matter with what I'm wearing?
It looks like it ought to have a fried egg on the pocket. You're in trouble, kid. If you keep acting like a stuffed shirt stockbroker, you're going to turn into one.
Why would I put up with this, Fred?
You're nuts about me. In fact, I've got a great idea. Why don't you come to London with me?
Reno.
We'll do the town upright. Buckingham Palace, Big Ben, the bushes in Hyde Park.
Reno, be serious.
I am serious. Come with me, Billy. England won't be the same without you.
You won't miss me over there. Guys like me are a dime a dozen.
Why are the cute ones always so dumb? My story is much too sad to be told.
world, but practically everything leaves me totally cold. The only exception I know is the case when I'm out on a quiet spree, fighting vainly the old ennui, and I suddenly turn and see your fabulous face. I get no kick from champagne. Beer alcohol doesn't thrill me at all. So tell me, why should it be true that I get a kick out of you? Some like that perfume from Spain. I'm sure that if I took even one sniff, that would bore me terrifically too. Yet I get a kick out of you. I get a kick every time I see you're standing there before me. I get a kick, though it's clear to me you obviously don't adore me. Some get a kick in a plane, flying too high with some guy in the sky is my idea of nothing to do. Yet I get a kick out of you.
I'm in love.
Oh, and I'm in cabin 13. Meet me right after we sail.
Come on, Reno, not with you. I'm in love with a girl. God, she's fantastic. She's so fantastic that she won't even talk to me. That's why I can't go to London in the morning, Reno. I have to stay here.
So that's it, eh? All this time you were just giving me the runaround?
The runaround?
You had me thinking you wanted to marry me.
Reno, I always treated you with respect.
Exactly. Did you ever try to get me drunk? No. Did you ever take me up into your apartment to take a look at your etchings? No. We've been in a taxi dozens of times, and did you ever once grope? No. Not one lousy grope. You shouldn't have let me on like that if you didn't mean it.
Reno, I never meant to mislead you.
The hell you didn't. You never even laid a hand on me. And I'm not used to men treating me like that.
My dear, you're sailing off without me. Yet you don't seem to give a damn.
I know it's fearful of me not to be more cheerful, but thank heaven I am.
You mean to say you're glad to leave me? Can I believe that's what you mean?
Why, don't be funny, I'm just wild about you, honey, but I'm oh so glad, so glad. It's driving me mad to say goodbye for the things that typify the humps of my daily routine.
There's no cure like travel to help you unravel the worries of living today. When the poor brain is dragging, there's nothing like packing a suitcase and sailing away. Take your mind round Vienna, Granada, Havana, Seattle, and get around Rome. I'm a high time, all the time, and in no time you'll be singing on.
Captain, a catastrophe. We may have to delay the sailing.
What is it? Icebergs, a hurricane?
Worse. And Charlie Chaplin just wired. He's canceling his berth and sailing on the Mauritania.
Good God. The passenger list, quick! Hope Park wrote the debutante. That's not bad.
The Normandy has Jimmy Walker and Machine Gun Kelly.
Lord Evelyn Oakley?
Nothing. Wealthy Englishman.
Wait a minute! Benjamin Franklin.
It's not the same one.
Then we got nobody! Quick, head down to the store club and see if anyone's left over from last night.
Aye, aye, sir.
Ladies, please.
Ah, gentlemen of the press. I am the Reverend Henry G. Dobson.
You're not the Henry G. Dobson.
As you've no doubt heard, I am on my way to attend the Westminster Conference, where I shall present my new two converts, Luke and John. Luke here was a compulsive gambler. As a reminder of his former shame, he still carries around with him a deck of cards. John was a compulsive drinker.
Are you swinging? All right, now we're getting somewhere. I'll say, take a swingy. Put it in on board this bar.
Same thing I do in my nightclub. I'll be saving sinners twice a night in the ship's lounge.
I see you brought the sinners with you.
Meet my angels. Purity.
Hi.
Chastity.
Hi.
Charity.
Hi.
Temperance.
Hi.
Harmony.
And I'm Virtue.
Hi.
The easy kind, no doubt.
Say, brother, was that a pass?
Miss Sweetie, I have no interest in either you or your fallen angels. I am ashamed to be seen in public with you.
How about a picture? Oh, and make sure to send one to the Archbishop.
Reverend! Reverend!
Bye!
I tell you, it ain't easy being New York's most notorious evangelist. Come, who will lead this sinner beside distilled waters? Which way to the bar? Thank you.
Hey, girls, how about a hallelujah?
Hallelujah. Hey, what?
Days are over. She's about to be married.
Married? Come on.
On the level?
Yes, it's true. I'm marrying Lord Evil at Oakley. We're going to be married aboard ship, and I'm very, very happy.
Hey, Edith, how about a smooch?
I beg your pardon?
That's a kiss from Addis?
No. How marvelous. You know, I'm making a list of the expressions you Americans use. A smooch is a kiss. I say, darling, how about a smooch?
Evangeline Harcourt!
Elijah Whitney!
Down, boy, down!
Eli, you haven't changed in 40 years!
Me? Look at you. You always did know how to fill a girdle.
Eli, really? You might have some respect for the memory of my late husband.
Of course, of course. You know, if it's any consolation, I was just coming off the stock exchange when I saw him take off from that ledge. He jumped like a Yale man.
Thank you, Eli.
Oh, my God.
Oh, you know my daughter, Hope, and this is her fiancé, Lord Evelyn Oakley.
Her fiancé?
Foreign word, Crocker, means to get married.
I don't believe it.
Oh, I hardly believe it either. Yet in 2 days, my little Hope is going to be a lady.
Sensational. This calls for a drink. Come along, everybody.
Isn't Mr. Crocker going to join us?
No, no. Mr. Crocker has a date on Wall Street. Get going, Crocker. Sell those chairs.
Hope. Wait. All ashore, let's go ashore. All ashore, let's go ashore. 7 a.m., you'll do your morning prayers. 8 a.m., you'll do your catechisms. And 9 a.m., you'll do my shirts.
Yes, Father!
Hey, you. Have you seen a minister?
A what?
FBI, looking for a gangster that's dressed up like a minister. Have you seen
him? He went that way. No, look, guys, I don't have time for this.
Millie, the coast is clear.
Are we in England yet?
Where's Snake Eyes? He hasn't shown.
To hell with Snake Eyes. He's public enemy number one. He can take care of himself.
You don't suppose the cops nabbed him? Oh, my God. I gotta find him.
Well, keep it down. Trying to make a getaway here.
Right. Snake Eyes! Snake Eyes!
Hey, shh! Whoa!
Hey!
My Stradivarius. Whoa! A fellow cleric. Allow me to present myself, Doctor. I am the Reverend Henry T. Dodson. Are you on your way to the conference? Actually, I thought I'd go to bed early tonight. I mean the Westminster Conference.
Oh, but you see, I'm not really a Westminster. I'm really more in the East.
What did you feel, Doctor?
Why, I'm sort of a kind of a missionary.
A missionary? Where?
Way out in China.
Oh, China.
Way, way out in China.
I served in China for years.
Oh, but you see, I wasn't really in China. I was more...
Oh, I see. You were in Indochina.
That's it. I was in indoor China. And you were in...
outdoor China. Well, plenty to talk about then. Dolly, she might die.
I don't know, but I think it's downstairs.
There he is! FBI, gentlemen!
Release me this instant! I'm the Reverend Henry T. Dobson!
Reverend! Oh my God! He's gone! Who will lead us not into temptation? What are we going to do?
Excuse me. Captain! Is there a casino on the ship?
Why, no.
Oh, there is now!
Mother, look!
I just wanted to wish the lady bon voyage, boss.
Crocker, I have 3 words of advice for you. Get off the boat!
Moon, I can't find Snake Eyes anywhere. What'll I do? He's my man! He's my life!
Forget about Snake Eyes.
Okay.
Final call! All ashore, the Jersey Shore!
You blew it, Snake Eyes! Now what do I do with this popcorn ticket?
Ooh! Could you let me have
him? And who are you?
Give him the goods. He saved my butt.
Murray Hill Flowers. Murray Hill Flowers? Where did I get a name like that?
The Yellow Pages!
Final call! All ashore, the Jersey Shore! Final call!
What am I doing? I'm supposed to be down on Wall Street!
Bon voyage!
Bon voyage!
I hate to say goodbye, sweetheart, by the seashore. I'll wait and watch the sea till you come back to me, oh my dearie. I'm yours for life. Kiss me, pretty wench, in English or in French. Bon voyage, bon voyage. And as though your mind traveled to help you unravel the worries of the new day. When the four place is cracking, there's nothing like adding
to see.
Forget about me and go after Miss Fantastic.
I did. She's on the boat.
Fantastic.
You know, I'm a mess. I'm gonna lose my job. My boss is gonna lose his shirt. All for some damn dame.
She must be some damned dame.
She is. You're gonna love her, Reno. Her name's Hope. Hope Harcourt.
Hope Harcourt? The debutante Hope Harcourt. The one who came out on a Zeppelin? The one who chases foxes on the cover of Life?
What are you saying? She's out of my league?
Billy!
Ah, how big she is.
Billy!
No, no, I can see it now. People like me deliver her groceries. They don't walk her down the aisle. Besides, she's getting married to some English guy, an earl or something.
Billy, where's the old Crocker confidence? You think some teabag can compare with you? You think he's got one tiny fraction of your brains, your looks, your... Add words poetic, I'm so pathetic that I always have found it best, instead of getting them off my chest, to let them rest unexpressed. I hate parading my serenading, as I'll probably miss a bar. But if this ditty is not so pretty, at least it'll tell you how great you are. You're the top, you're the Colosseum, you're the top, you're the Louvre Museum, you're a melody from a symphony by Strauss, you're a Bendel bonnet, a Shakespeare sonnet, you're a Mickey Mouse. You're the Nile, you're the Tower of Pisa, you're the smile on the Mona Lisa. I'm a worthless check, a total wreck, a flop, but if maybe I'm the bottom, you're the top.
Oh, hold on a minute here. Your words poetic, I'm not pathetic. On the other hand, baby, shine. Let me feel after every line, thrill line, down my spine. Gifted humans like Benson humans might think that your song is bad, but I got the notion, I'll second the motion, and this is what I'm going to add. You're the top, you're Mahatma Gandhi, you're the top, you're Napoleon Brandy, you're the purple light of summer night in Spain, you're the National Gallery, you're Gabo Salvi, you're cellophane, you're sublime, you're a turkey dinner, you're the time of the Derby winner, I'm the toy balloon that's fated soon to pop, but if baby I'm the bottom, you're the top.
Dollar. You're the nimble tread of the feet of Fred Astaire. You're an audio drama.
You're Mrs. Mama.
You're the Camembert.
All right, now. You're Rose. You're Infernus Chatty.
You're the nose. I'm the great Durancy. I'm just in the way, as the French would say, to Trump.
You're an angel, you simply too to be. You're a Botticelli, you're Keaton,
Shelley,
you're Rosie. You're a moon, you're the damn at Boulder, you're the moon over Mae West's shoulder. I'm the nominee of the GOP.
Or not.
But if maybe I'm the bottom, you're the top.
You're romance, you're the sex of Russia, you're the best.
Try taking deep breaths, dear. That always helps me. Maybe you should go lie down.
And leave you alone? Wouldn't dream of it. Besides, I'll be right as rain as soon as we escape these swells.
But the sea's as flat as a pancake, dear.
Oh, please hope I really wish you meant mention food just now.
Sorry, I'll go get you a bromo.
Thank you.
Hey, Hope, how you doing?
Hello, Billy. Billy!
You know, you're beautiful when you're about to faint.
Billy! What are you doing here? I didn't know you were sailing.
Oh, I didn't either.
What are you doing here?
Oh, I'm selling lifeboats. Hope, I just thought a way to be with you. I couldn't let you go.
Billy, this is my fiancé, Lord Evil and Oakley.
Billy Crocker, pleased to meet you.
Forgive me, I rather overdid it in the dining hall.
Oh, me too. Did you have the sweetbread? Best brains I ever ate.
Billy!
Oh, I've never seen a served way before with the, jellied eels and the head cheese.
Stop it!
Nitro!
Billy, was that fair?
Fair? I find you standing here in the moonlight with him. I didn't shoot him. I didn't push him overboard. I thought I was more than fair.
You're being terribly bad, Billy. We hardly know each other.
Hardly know each other?
We met one night at a party. We danced. Had a little too much wine. Took a little spin around the park.
You call 5 hours in the back of a taxi cab a little spin?
4 hours.
Five. Remember you fell asleep after we...
I remember.
And then I took you down to that little cafe down by the docks.
We had breakfast when the sun came up.
Talked about going to California, getting a little bungalow, raising some orange trees.
Raising kids. Billy, that was just a fantasy. Things like that just aren't done.
I guess you're right. Me and you? Who am I naming?
I know too well that I'm just wasting precious time in thinking such a thing could be, that you could ever care for me. I know you hate to hear that I adore you, dear, but grant me just the same. I'm not entirely to blame for you being so easy to love, so easy to idolize all others. Sit down at 8:10, bacon with. We'd be so grand and gay, so carefree together, that it does seem a shame that you can't see your future with me, 'cause you'd be oh so. Or even three, four.
that.
You can change that. All you have to do is...
No. If you don't let me alone, I'll make a scene.
Hope, you love me. You're gonna marry me.
Captain.
to serve you, Doctor, but does a Mr. Murray know flowers occupy this counter?
Oh, not very often. Why do you ask?
There's a radiogram from Washington. The man you're traveling with is not Murray Hill Flowers. He's Snake Eyes Johnson, Public Enemy Number One.
Public Enemy Number One?
Santo Domingo!
Don't worry, Doctor. My man can handle it. If he does turn up, just give a shout.
Ouch! Oh. Just practicing. Ouch! Oh.
Doc, stop me if I'm out of line, but I don't think you're really a minister.
Kid, I'm gonna level with you. I'm not a minister. I'm Moonface Mon, the famous gangster.
Yeah, Public Enemy Number 13. How? Police.
Oh, you're not gonna turn me in, are you?
Doc, relax. We're pals.
Then where are you going?
I got a wedding to bust up.
You can't go out there. The captain thinks you're Snake Eyes Johnson.
What I need is a disguise.
Yeah, a gorilla suit. Or a set of armor.
Or a sailor suit.
You want a sailor suit? No problem.
Sailor's life is supposed to be a heck of a lot of fun.
Yes, but when you're a sailor, take it from me. Work like a son of a gun.
They give us jobs of every kind and chores of every sort.
But sweat away, sailor, you don't mind, 'cause you know when we reach port, there will always be a lady.
Who can have been famous in this sinking?
Do you think I have time to go
word to anyone.
Mother! Well, I hope you're proud of yourself, Billy.
As a matter of fact, I am. 12 hours ago, you said you never wanted to see me again, and now I have you all to myself.
Maybe not quite all to yourself. Good morning, Mr. Whitney.
Morning, miss. I'm looking for a sailor.
Well, why don't you just take a look at this one?
I want to send a wire. This goes to a Mr. William Crocker, Whitney Building, New York City. Crocker, wire confirmation of amalgamated sale at once. You got that?
Better have him read it back.
Crocker! Wire confirmation of amalgamated sale at once!
You remind me of someone.
Look out!
I don't see it. Oh, God, what's that?
Biggest seagull I ever saw!
Oh! Got her up. See you later.
Crazy good luck, Reno Sweeney. I say, why don't we all have tea in my cabin? I know my fiance, Miss Harcourt, would love to meet you.
That's very sweet, but I'm afraid.
She'd love to! Marvelous! Shall we say 4 o'clock?
4 o'clock.
Meters. See you later, elevator.
Cabin early, wearing something that slips off easy. Then I bust in and catch him tearing it clothes off. Then we blackmail him into breaking the engagement.
Moon, that's despicable.
You don't like it?
I love it.
You know, Reno, we should have cleaned up years ago.
We're two of a kind, all right.
Partners.
Through thick or thin.
Night or day.
Right or wrong.
If you're ever in a jam, here I am.
If you ever need a pal, I'm your gal.
If you ever feel so happy you land in jail, I'm your bell.
It's friendship, friendship, just the perfect friendship. When other friendships have been forgot, ours will still be hot. La la la, ding ding ding.
Bell.
If you ever catch on fire, send the wire.
If you ever lose your cheek when you're out to dine, far and wide, it's friendship, friendship, just the perfect friendship. When other friendships have ceased to gel, ours will still be swell. La la la, hep hep hep.
If they ever block your eyes,
if they ever hook your goats, turn me loose.
If they ever put up under your brain, I'll complain.
It's friendship, friendship, just the perfect friendship. When other friendships go up in smoke, ours will still be up. La la la, boo boo boo. If you ever lose your mind, I'll be kind. If you're ever in a mailing get sawed in half, I won't laugh. It's friendship, friendship, just the perfect friendship. When other friendships have been forgate, ours will still be great.
If they ever crack your spine, drop a line.
If they ever cut your throat, write a note.
Oh, really? If they ever make a cannibal stew of you,
what?
What were you going to do if it was cold? Cut off his head?
You mean Excalibur. It's an old family heirloom, and Mother Harcourt wanted me to wear it for the ceremony. It's like the old Jesus is taking with things English as I am with things American.
Well, I'm glad you feel that way, because this American certainly feels gaga about you.
Oh, gaga. I'm not sure I follow.
I mean, you do things to me.
Do things to you?
I mean, you send me.
Send you where?
One look at you and I get hot pants.
Oh dear me, would a bit of ice do any good?
Evie, hot pants means that I'm crazy about you.
Oh, hot pants means that you're crazy about me. Oh, smashing because I think you're the rat's pajamas. The absolute flea's knees.
I say something funny.
Yeah, but it's also kind of cute.
Aha! What's going on here? So this is what I find! You beast! You despoiler of innocent girlhood! Look at this poor child, her clothes all torn off by your fiendish attack, standing there in her nakedness!
There's something wrong here.
There's nothing wrong here.
Hey, Moonface, hold on!
No, stand back! I won't permit this British lion to twist American womanhood by the tail. Do you think your girlfriend will marry you after this?
I don't think she won't know, because I'm gonna tell her.
Oh, do you only lay it on a bit thicker? She does complain that I laugh further.
Now, wait a minute, Buster. You're not taking the right attitude. I'm a dangerous man.
Oh, go on, Padre. You're an old sweetheart, and you know it.
All right. You asked for it. I'm gonna prove to you I'm a desperate character. Now, you wait right here. No, wait right here. I won't be long.
You know, I've noticed that these clergy sometimes go a bit off.
Well, Evie, there's something I've gotta tell you. This was a setup.
A setup?
We were going to frame you.
Frame me?
He was supposed to bust in and catch us in a clinch.
Oh, I see. You don't mean he thought I'd make love to you?
That was the idea.
Oh, this is exciting!
You mean you and me?
You see? Now I guess you realize how serious this is!
Moon, are you nuts? Put that thing away!
No.
Put it down!
It's all right, Padre. You thought I'd take advantage of Miss Sweetie here, and you came to her rescue. I really admire you for it. I admire you enormously. And what's the expression? I've got hot pants for you!
You stay away from me or I'll shoot!
Evening, folks. I trust you're enjoying the crossing. What about, Gertrude Ederling?
The channel swimmer? Is she on board?
Well, not exactly, but... There she goes!
What does Hope see in that guy? It must be her mother. She's the one who's behind all this.
I could kill the mother!
Moon.
Okay. I'll think of another plan.
Hope it's better than the last one.
Have you signed that criminal yet, man?
Not yet, sir.
Apprehend that man immediately.
Yes, sir. Sir.
And if you see any celebrities, apprehend them too.
Aye, aye, sir. Aye, aye, sir.
Did you hear that? I've got to do something about this disguise.
Stay out of the kitchen or I'll put you on the menu. Sailor, find out who this belongs to.
Aye, aye, sir. If only I had a... foamy beard or a mustache.
Cheeky! Cheeky! Oh, where is that dog?
Now, now. They always find their way home.
His home is an oyster bed, Long Island.
Be calm, my dear. You're like a trembling fawn. Here, have a snort.
I told you, Eli. Liquor has never touched my lips.
You know a shortcut? Oh, Evangeline, would you just look at that moon? Ah, yes, this was a night made for romance. My dear, will you marry me?
I can't, sir, I'm already married.
What?
But there's a lady around the corner looking for a dog. Why don't you try her?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
To get rid of that thing!
Certainly!
When is it this time, madam?
I
it's right beside your little nosy.
What to do that for?
Oh, relax. Dogs are good swimmers. Excuse me, ma'am. We're looking for Lord Evelyn Oakley. Have you seen him?
Well, I should say so. He's going to marry my daughter. Is something the matter?
Oh, allow me to introduce myself. I am Lord Evelyn Oakley. The man, as you know, is Lord Evelyn Oakley. He's been auntie my brother, Edna.
Your brother, Edna?
His real name's Mona, but he changed it. He's deranged!
Several years ago, he escaped my family suite at Bedlam.
Oh, you have a family suite at Bedlam?
I was taking him down to Sego Row for a new straitjacket when he gave me the slip.
Who is this man?
Oh, this is my brother's keeper.
Oh, dear me, this is most upsetting.
Don't worry, we know how to handle him.
We've been through this a million times.
Oh, you mean this has happened before?
He marries him, he murders him. He marries him, he murders him.
He murders their mother.
Oh, but he seems so normal.
Aha! She doesn't know the signs.
Telltale signs.
The fatal signs.
What signs? What signs?
Well, there's a certain phrase that he uses.
Just before he snaps.
Have you ever heard him say? Oh, what
ho?
That's
it! Now, shh! I've been looking for you everywhere, Mums. I say, how do you like it? Dear me, is she all right? Oh, she's fine. She's just playing dead. Sit up. Roll over.
What do we do?
Oh, about 5 years. Waste time off with behavior.
Oh, my God. Mother? Mother? Billy, what have you done?
Hope I can explain everything.
I don't want to hear it, Billy.
It's delirious, it's the lemon, it's the lemon, it's the loops, it's the lovely.
while you crucify the verse.
This verse I've started seems to me the tinny antithesis of melody.
So spare us all the pain. Just skip the darn thing and sing the refrain.
Me, 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 ray, 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 do so we do not see. The night is young, the skies are clear, and if you want to go walking, dear, it's delightful, it's delicious, it's lovely. I understand the reason why you're sentimental, because so am I. It's delightful, it's delicious, it's lovely. You can tell.
For a game of shuffleboard?
Captain, we've got, ladies and gentlemen, no cause for alarm.
What did he do? Is he a stowaway?
Ladies and gentlemen, the man we just arrested is Snake Eyes Johnson, public enemy number one. Take him away, man.
Oh.
Do anything, release that man! But I thought you had been clapped in irons.
Clapped in irons? A celebrity like Snake Eyes Johnson?
Let me get this straight. If I'm just a stowaway, you throw me in jail. But if I'm a famous murderer, you roll out the red carpet?
You'll be my guest for their dinner at the captain's table.
You know, he's not the only gangster on this ship.
What do you mean, Doctor?
I mean I'm not a minister. I'm Moonface Mon. I'm a public enemy too.
Public enemy number two?
Yeah.
Moon?
Shut up, Irma.
Ladies and gentlemen, it appears we have not one,
but two famous criminals on board. Let's make them feel at home.
Can I touch your trigger finger?
Mr. Johnson, can I have your autograph?
Have you ever killed anyone who looks like me?
Come on, baby. Room for one more.
Oh, go on, darling. It looks like fun.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the honorary captain of the SS American. Three cheers for Snake Eyes Johnson! Hip hip hooray! Hip hip hooray! Hip hip hooray!
Times have changed, and we've often rewound the clock since the Puritans got a shock when they landed on Plymouth Rock. If today any shock they should try to instead of landing on Plymouth Rock would land on them. In olden days, a glimpse of stocking was looked on as something shocking, but now God knows anything goes. But others too, who once knew better words, now only use four-letter words, writing prose.
happy number one.
Only happy number one. No.
He's always happy. He's full of stuff.
The stuff, full of stuff.
It's time for doing the magic cap. He's throwing a party on behalf of the world. Only happy number one.
Only happy number one.
It's been my downfall.
was visiting China some time ago, there was this little Chinese girl named Plum Blossom, of whom I became extremely fond. Eventually, we had an unpremeditated romp in the rice, and I enjoyed it very much.
You know, brother, I was worried about you, but I feel much better now.
Hallelujah!
Do you hear that playing?
Yes, I hear that playing.
Do you know who's playing?
No, who is that playing?
Why, it's Gabriel, Gabriel playing. Gabriel, Gabriel saying, will you be ready to go when I blow my heart? Come blow, Gabriel, blow. Come on and blow, Gabriel, blow. I've been a sinner, I've been a scamp, but now I'm willing to trim my lamp. So blow, Gabriel, blow. I was low, Gabriel, blow. Mighty low, Gabriel, blow. But now since I have seen the light, I'm good by day and I'm good by night. So blow, Gabriel, blow. Once I was headed for hell. Once I was headed for hell. But when I got to Satan's door, I heard you blowing on the horn once more. So I said, say to farewell. And now I'm all ready to fly. Yes, to fly higher and higher and higher. Cause I've gone through brimstone and I've been through the fire. And I purged my soul and my heart to climb up the mountaintop and soar to glory.
Play all day in the promise lands of love.
I'll give you a confession. 3 weeks ago, I met a girl and fell in love with her. And how did I show it? I hounded her. I embarrassed her. I made her cry. I'm sorry, Hope. I just want you to be happy. I'll never bother you again.
What is this?
He doesn't sound like Snake Eyes.
I'm not a gangster. I'm just a broken down broker.
Make sure they're getting irons!
Get behind me, kid, or shoot our way out. There's definitely something wrong here. When you know you're headed for the jail,
la la. Be like a bluebird who never is blue, for he knows from his upbringing what singing can do. And though by other birdies in the mountains may be told that his efforts are perfectly lousy, he sings on and on till his troubles are through. Tweet, tweet. Tra-la, la-la, la-la.
Ah. Moonlight by Lord Evelyn Oakley. A lonely figure walks the deck, the moonlight glancing off his beano. Tis not the ship, tis he the wreck. His heart dashed on a girl named Miss Sweeney. I see you startled me.
I couldn't sleep.
All right.
The Lord works in mysterious ways, Evie, but this time he's got even me stymied. My two best friends are in the slammer, and tomorrow morning... Well, hey, you know all about that. Here's to the happy groom. Make that, here's to the groom.
Miss Sweeney, you see before your man staggered by revelation. It hit me like a stone hammer in the middle of your service. The woman I'm destined to marry tomorrow is not one and the same with the woman I love.
You mean you're not in love with Hope? That's great! Oh, I mean, that's great. I'm glad you found out. Just in time and everything.
Thanks a lot. Do you know the Oakley family motto? Nostrum fugilium centaurum.
What's that mean?
No one really knows. But we're not supposed to go around backing out of engagements. Oh well, the gym is swinging.
You know, there's one thing I can't figure. That business in the rice paddy, plum blossom. How does that fit in with nostrium fugilium whatever?
Dear me, this is most embarrassing. Must I explain?
It's your motto.
Never told this to anyone before, Miss Sweeney. It's the Oakley family secret. There's something dark and savage in our blood. Mine especially. You see, long, long ago, so long ago, I hardly know it. My great-great-grandmother now and then stepped out with a jet suit. Of course, you will say she was a little bit tipsy. But tipsy, no. Of their love, there wasn't a doubt. So I can't wait to get stage or set so I can let the gypsy in me out. Hiding away, there's a little bit of gypsy in me that's never been found. Making its day, there's a little bit of gypsy in me just hanging around. Till the magical night, when the stars unite, give mystery to the sleeping black moon. While the haunting guitar, not a mere, not a far, gaily hums away, strums away, a titillating tune. When I'm there in the dream, I worship passionately at the moment supreme. Will be shared your nerves, gypsy and me.
Behave yourselves.
What's going on? They'll only be in for an hour. They cleaned out third class to make crap since some folks got pretty hot about it.
What about us? When are we getting out?
I knew this would happen. I hope you're satisfied.
You know what your problem is, kid? You ain't got no philosophy. There's an old Australian bush song.
Would they cut it out? What time is it?
Half past.
Half past what?
I don't know. I lost the little hand.
Hope is getting married at 9. We gotta do something.
You bums.
Reno!
Boys, I've got fabulous news. The greatest thing that could happen to a person just happened to me.
You got paroled.
Nah, she's in love.
And what's more, Evie's in love with me.
That's great. In fact, that's perfect.
Yeah, you marry Evelyn, Billy marries Hope. Well, that just leaves one little problem.
What's that?
Well, how shall I put it? Let me out! Let me out! Let me out!
Reno, we gotta think of something.
If only we were Chinese.
Chinese?
They're getting out in an hour. Say, old buddies. Up for a little game of poker?
Sure.
Brother who can't play cards, the person took his money. Oh,
that's okay. We'll play strip poker. If I lose, I take off all my clothes. And if you lose...
Ah! Teresa, Teresa!
Pardon me, your shoe's untied. Your deal.
Billy, you're high. What do you bet?
I bet coat.
Do you stay coat?
I stay coat.
You stay coat.
I stay coat.
I stay coat. We all stay coat. You're high. What do you bet?
I bet pants.
You call pants?
I call pants.
You call pants.
I call pants.
Call it all pants. Call it all pants. Call it all... pants.
What?
Irma, marry me.
No, Irma, marry me.
No, marry me, Irma.
No, me. Come on, Irma. We're gonna have one wedding. Why not two?
Come on, fellas. Getting married's for the birds. Who needs it?
We do.
Yeah.
I prefer the first row.
are gathered here together over the bodies of... We are assembled here to join in the bonds of holy matrimony. This young...
Stop! Stop!
Stop! Stop! Stop!
What's this?
We come long way. Travel far to have big talk with English gentlemen. We arrive in nick of time.
I'm afraid if you come in reference to my Hong Kong interest, you've come at a bad moment. About to be married.
No, no, no can marry.
No can marry. No can marry.
Oh, why no can marry? I mean, why can't they be married?
Listen, I explain. I have honor to introduce Wu Changmun, father of Ritter from Russia.
And who is Ritter from Russia?
Yes, who is Ritter from Russia?
This is Ritter from Russia. Riddle Chinese princess, until Lord Everin turned her into Riddle Chinese trap!
I'm not sure I follow this.
Lord Everin, take Prom Rossum into Rice Paddy and bring back Prom Tart!
Oh, dear me, is this really true?
I'm afraid so. East is East and all that, and I have to admit for a brief moment our twains did meet.
And how? Along soon come Riddle Prom Pudding!
What?
Evelyn! Is this woman really Prom Rossum?
I don't know. All happened so long ago.
Long, long ago, so long ago.
Apologies! To one and all, but under the circumstances, I don't see how I could possibly marry Miss Hong Kong.
Don't be ridiculous. All these people want is money. Look, you two, I'll give you $1,000 each to clear out of here.
We'll take it.
Do not insult us with offer of filthy money. I'll make it $2,000. Rich man cannot buy a Chinese honor. $5,000.
Chinese honor sold.
No, Mr. Whitney, don't pay him. No amount of money can settle this great wrong. You, sir, you are a relative of Riddle Prom Rossum?
We are poker buddies.
Then the only way to repay this debt of honor, Evelyn, is for you to offer him me.
I say, what a marvelous idea.
Oh, no!
Offer accepted, Chinese honor saved!
But what about the live ram?
Congratulations. Old boy, you're getting quite the girl.
Why not English gentlemen join club and right wrong done call Prom Rossum?
What?
Right wrong done war Prom Rossum.
Oh, I see. See here, little Prom Rossum. Will you marry me?
Sweetie, I thought you'd never ask.
Why, after that amalgamated deal, I'll be so damn rich I could buy the stinking tub and make it into your own private yacht.
Oh, Eli, my savior, my knight in shining armor.
Ah, Mr. Whitney.
Crap!
Hi, boss.
I didn't know you were Chinese.
I'm not, friend. I have another confession to make. I never made it to Wall Street. I stowed away on the boat. I never sold the ship.
You never. But that would mean that I'm ruined.
Ah! I'm sorry, boss.
Well, at least I have someone to comfort me in my misfortune.
Well,
Mr. Whitney, urgent cable from New York. Amalgamated just went through the roof. You're a zillionaire!
Eli!
How do you do it, boss?
Huh? I'll tell you how. Brains, guts, and the world's finest education. Bow-dow, bow-wow! Eli Zill!
Speaking of dogs, does this belong to anybody?
Oh. Cheeky! Where have you been?
The swimming pool.
champagne.